Hey, what's up? Sammy here. This is x2M1 from Makeblock. It's not only for laser cutting, but also for blade cutting. And I've been with it for some days and tremendous things you can think of. So how is it? And what's new about it compared to the laser engravers I've reviewed before? Let's dive into it. I want to start off by saying that this video is not getting paid for by the Makeblock company, but I work at the official unit once the crowdfunding campaign has ended, because I liked it and asked to keep one for my own use. So for this review, it's based on this prototype I have now. The official unit might be different in the end. Normally, from my experience, it would be better and improved. And if you are interested in this product, you can find the link in the description. Also, please don't forget to subscribe. It's free. You won't lose anything. Now, moving to the x2M1. Unlike those open-style laser engravers we normally see, this M1 is fully concealed in a safe and sound white box. On the front outside shell, we see the logo and the start pause button. On the back, we have the power button, USB port, power port, extension port, and the smoke outlet. On the top is the lid, yet it's not just a lid. It features blue light to protect your eyes, and when you open it, the engraving stops automatically. Safety matters! As for what's inside, in order to show us clearly, Makeblock was kind enough to supply another machine with part of the outer shell cut off. Rich people! Inside we see the laser head. It also integrates a knife module. You can either take it out or install it like the video shows. If you are wondering what the blade cut is, it's just using this sharp blade to cut stuff. We also find a camera inside, which they use for a really interesting function that I will talk about later. Beyond those, there is a chain that drives the laser head to move around. That's basically all the design. For me, I really like it. It's minimalistic, elegant, and safe. I can just leave there to engrave or check my Tinder without worrying about anything. Since the M1 offers laser cutting, engraving, and blade cutting, I'm all good with the size. Not too heavy, and I can still have fun with it. Now, let's talk about the real stuff, the engraving and cutting ability. First, I want to start with something new that I haven't seen on other laser cutters, which is the blade cutting. There are many benefits for blade cutting, like for soft materials like vinyl. It normally cannot handle heat very well. Laser cutting would justly burn edges and generate toxic fumes. Blade cutting instead can perform perfect clean cutting. Thus, it's the perfect solution. Now I'm going to show you how the blade cutting works. They have a fancy name for it called Bring Sketch to Life. Namely, you draw or write whatever sketch you like, put it into the x2M1 box, and then place the material you want to cut beside. Here I'm using the vinyl sheet because I want to stick that to my clothes. Then go to the Laserbox app, click the plus icon. The camera inside the M1 box then identifies the material and transfers the sketch to the app. Follow the prompts on the screen to draw a square around the image to extract it, and magically, the image you drew is separated. You can rotate it, resize it, and place it where you want to blade cut. After that, click on flat surface mode, then choose blade cutting mode, and then adjust the cut pressure and speed. Currently, the Makeblock team is finalizing the app. I have to do this manually. Later, when you get the face unit, you won't need to adjust all of those parameters. It will automatically feed at the recognize all the cutting stuff. And then press start on the top right corner. Lastly, you press the start or pause button on the machine to start. Once it finishes, the indicator on the start button turns to flashing green. To be honest, I'm really surprised how well and delicate it cut. Not too deep or too shallow, just good enough. After that, just peel off the rest and leave the drawings and the stickers. And then I used a nylon to stick to my t-shirt. Though I'm not a DIY guy and have little interest in customizing something to my t-shirt. Man, I just loved it. And if you compare with the original drawings I drew, it's an accurate cut. And if you are wondering if the stickers last long, it seems it resists water washing quite well, at least for once. Secondly, I'm also impressed by the laser cutting of the x2M1. According to the Makeblock team, they use a diode laser head, and the 10-watt version can cut up to 8mm bezel in a single pass. I didn't have one with that thickness, but I tested on a 3mm wood, and it cuts perfectly. I made a cute phone stand for myself. Like I said, I'm not a DIY guy, but if you are, then just imagine what you can do with this little cute machine. They also have a 5-watt version, which I also think is enough for home use. Thirdly, I'd like to mention the rotary attachment. It's optional and you can use it to engrave cylindrical objects ranging from 3 to 70 mm in diameter. This means you can easily engrave something like rings or bottles.
While the latter would take some extra work, you would have to remove the base and lift the machine with four wooden supports officially provided. They are included in the package, by the way. But I guess it's totally worth the hassle, especially when you see the results. Speaking of engraving results, as always, I tried numerous prints and numerous materials. Wood, bamboo, sorry, it's a bit off the center, leather, ceramic, black stones, tile, stainless steel, aluminum cord, and even cookies. The image quality is just mind-blowing. They look crystal clear and the main details are kept. All look nice and sharp with high definition. No visible flaws or had any significant problems. It definitely has one of the best performances among all the laser engravers I've tested so far. You can go as creative as you want, or if you are too lazy, you can just apply the default models in the software and the choices are also plenty. Now to my conclusion. I've got to say I'm really impressed with the xTool M1. It combines the laser cutter and blade cutter so well that it enables you to create something on the widest range of materials as possible. If you are a creator and want one flawless hybrid laser and blade cutter and engraver, I think this is the one. It's easy to use, you don't have to put too much effort on adjusting focus. With AI system and built-in smart camera, this laser cutter can automatically focus and detect the shape of the material and process the same ones in batches at one time. Another great highlight is safety. It's all in the box. Great for families with naughty kids or curious pets, isn't it? But just like reviewing all products, I will always point out the disadvantages in addition to all the good stuff. I think there's only one thing that exists for this product, and that's you will have to wait. You cannot get the xTool M1 shipped to you right now to use for a project. They are still finalizing the product, still tuning their software and testing all kinds of stuff. By the time I was reviewing it, I had to connect the machine to the computer to use. Good news is they are working on the phone app and things will be more convenient and easier. Also, it's a crowdfunding project, so the estimated delivery time would be about 2 or 3 months later. But if that's the only thing I point out, then there's really nothing to complain about it. After all, good products are worth waiting for. And I deeply believe Makeblock has every ability to bring this project to life and get it done. Do you believe more than 7 years ago I visited the Makeblock company when it was just a startup with tens of people? And now they have over 400 staff and with millions of users worldwide. And still, they're focusing on producing great products for different people. I think this is the faith. Alright, that's the video. If you are interested in this xTool M1, definitely give it a try. Link is in the description. Currently, it's at the crowdfunding campaign stage and has the best price ever. So, what will you do with it? Please let me know in the comment section. I'm Sammy, and we'll see you in the next one. He's so excited before that. Okay.